Hi, let's talk about the pericardium. In this video, we'll discuss the pericardium. The pericardium is a sac that surrounds the heart, which is comprised of two membranes that fall really into three layers. The outermost layer, which we can see here, is the fibrous pericardium. Deep to the fibrous pericardium is a mesothelial membrane called the serous pericardium, which has a parietal layer and a visceral layer. From what you understand about mesothelial membranes, you'll know that the parietal layer tends to adhere to the walls and the visceral layer adheres to the viscera, which we'll see. The pericardium as a unit is very helpful for navigating the mediastinum because its borders are what defines the middle mediastinum. Anything anterior to it is the anterior mediastinum. Anything posterior to it is the posterior mediastinum. We can see that it is falling within that mediastinal space, so medial to the pleura. And interestingly enough, it's fused to the central tendon of the diaphragm. Now, the fibrous pericardium is a rough and tumble sac. It's predominantly comprised of collagen, and so it's not elastic at all. It allows for the heart to expand during diastole, but it doesn't stretch. So here we can see the heart wall and the layers of the pericardium there. That outermost layer is the fibrous pericardium. So it's a collagenous trilayer with each layer woven at about 120 degrees angle with respect to the other. This provides a nice barrier between the heart and what's outside of the heart. So it's a physical barrier to prevent diseases. It's also a nice anchor for the heart within the mediastinal space. Deep to this fibrous pericardium is the parietal layer of the serous pericardium, also known as the parietal pericardium. So this is a serosal membrane. This is simple squamous epithelium with a basement membrane below it. The parietal layer of the serous pericardium is innervated by branches of the phrenic nerves. So for any pain, it's brought up through the roots of the phrenic nerve. So C345 keeps the diaphragm alive. Deep to this parietal pericardium is the pericardial cavity. And that pericardial cavity is surrounded on the inside or the deep side by that visceral layer of the pericardium. The pericardial cavity isn't so much a large patent space like one would presume, but we discuss it that way for the purposes of understanding. So if we move over here, we can relate the serous pericardium to a balloon that someone is invaginating their fist inward, so the space within the balloon is maintained, and then there is a visceral layer to this space and a parietal layer to this space as well. And the cavity is the space between these two layers. And as we can see here, there's the parietal pericardium that would adhere to the fibrous pericardium, and there's the visceral pericardium that would adhere to the heart itself and be known as the epicardium. So this pericardial cavity typically has not much in it, generally about 15 to 20 mils of a fluid known as ultrafiltrate that's secreted by the visceral layer. That visceral layer, even though it's mesothelium, is ciliated mesothelium. And so there's a lot of secretion from that layer to produce the ultrafiltrate. That visceral layer becomes the de facto surface of the heart, and so we call it the epicardium. Deep to the epicardium will be subserosal adipose connective tissue, and its thickness tends to be proportional to an individual's cardiometabolic risk level. So the more epicardial fat that is present, the greater the risk of coronary artery disease, hypertension, insulin resistance and diabetes, etc. The visceral layer of the epicardium is innervated by a different source than the parietal level. It's under autonomic control, so it's going to be subject to the whimsy of the cardiac plexus, which we'll discuss in a later video. The pericardium itself is supplied by pericardiacophrenic arteries. These are branches of the internal thoracic artery, which also serve the diaphragm. So pericardiacophrenic pericardium and phrenic diaphragm. So we've discussed the various layers of the pericardium, fibrous and serous, and we've discussed the layers of the serous pericardium, parietal and visceral, or epicardium, and the pericardial cavity between them. This is your summary slide. Thank you very much for your time.